On the 9th of Rabi al Awal, 12 Shias will be celebrating what is known as Eid al-Zahra. This month it will fall on the 26th of October. What many do not know is that this is a celebration of the slaughter of Omar ibn Al Khattab radiallahu anh by the Magian Abu Luluah. The killing of Omar is celebrated because Shias believe Omar killed the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Of course, this is one of many Rafidi fables concocted to create hatred for the Sahaba. We have thoroughly refuted it, and the 12 Shia polemicists who have attempted to prove its veracity. Before I explain how it is celebrated, let's recap on how Omar radiallahu anh was martyred. Abu Luluah al Majosi entered the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's mosque as Omar the Khalifa was leading Fajr Salah. Abu Luluah approached him as he was leading prayer and stabbed him multiple times, started running outside of the mosque, stabbing people on the way out. Eventually, when he was caught, he stabbed himself to death. Some narrations say he stabbed as many as 15 people and 7 Muslims died. This is the first terrorist attack in Islamic history, and the perpetrator of this attack, Abu Luluah al Majusi, is regarded as a saint in Twelver Shiism. It is mentioned in Sahih Muslim that after being stabbed, Omar asked if it was a Muslim that did this. Ibn Abbas said no, Omar said Alhamdulillah that the one who did this never prostrated to Allah. This is what the Shias are celebrating, a terrorist attack. Think about that for a second. What kind of a heroic act is this? Uthman was killed whilst reading Quran. Omar was killed whilst leading congregation. Ali was killed on the way to leading congregation. Subhanallah, these deaths are a sign from Allah. The killer of Ali was called Ibn Muljim, and the killer of Omar, Abu Luluah al-Majusi, is a bigger coward than Ibn Muljim. Ibn Muljim at least awaited his punishment. The coward, Abu Luluah al-Majusi, committed suicide to avoid any punishment that would come his way. So to the celebration. You may have noticed all over social media, Shias have started posting the letters B-U-L or B-U-L-B. When Shias use B-U-L or B-U-L-B, it means Bar Omar La'nat Bash Omar, or may curses be upon Omar endlessly. Of course, that's in Persian, the holy language of Rafidism. In typical cowardly Twelver taqiyya fashion, this celebration is hidden via an acronym to express their obsession with cursing. The next time you see these letters posted on social media, know that the one who posted it and the one who likes the post are celebrating the slaughter of Omar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anh. Shias disguise this celebration through taqiyya in order to not push Sunnis away from Shiism. Of course, taqiyya is a fundamental element of Twelver Shiism. They have attributed to Ja'far al-Sadiq that 9/10 of this religion is taqiyya, and there is no religion for he who has no taqiyya. And there are many similar narrations and statements of scholars promoting deception.
Ayatollah Khomeini specifically invokes taqiyya al-mudaratiyya, or taqiyya of ingratiation. He describes it in the following excerpt from Ar-Rasa'il, Volume 2, page 174, which states, "It is the act of making those who differ with us, Ahlus Sunnah, love us and to lure them by friendliness in a situation where there is no fear of harm or damage to the Shia, unlike the taqiyya of fear." In the following clips, you will see head of the Cultural and Belief Center in Qom, Iran, Ustad Bahjatpur, Ayatollah Muhammad Taqi Bahjat, and others encourage taqiyya when interacting with Sunnis.
من صحبت دیگه ای هم با برادران و خواهران شیعه دارم، پیروان مکتب اهل بیت. امامان معصوم ما توصیه فراوان کردند که تلاش کنید به اینها نزدیک بشید، نگرانی هاشون رو رفع کنید، در نمازهاشون شرکت کنید. امامان معصوم ما جملات بسیار مهمی در باب تقیه دارن. بفرماید امام صادق که التقیه تو دینی و دین آبایی، تقیه دین من و روش آبا و گذشتگان من است، و لا دین لمن لا تقیه له، کسی که تقیه نکند دین ندارن. مراد از تقیه صرفا تقیه خوفی و ناشی از ترس نیست، بلکه تقیه شامل تقیه تحبیبی هم می شود.
ارتد الناس بعد از الا سلاسه مستلاسه شد اندازه مثلا 500 میلیون تقیه این کارو بشه الا اگه از هم اول به سب و تعب و خدان این ها مشغول میشود مدا زیاد میشود.
درسته هرچه توی اهل سنت نزنید تقیه بکنید، ما از زمان پیغمبر از زمان اهل تمرین تقیه میکردیم تا حالا میکنیم، حرفی نداریم.
I mean, for example, sometimes you find our brothers from Ahlus Sunnah saying, you, the Shia, tell me your real beliefs. What's your real beliefs? Why don't you say your real beliefs in front of us? What are you doing? Taqiyya, you're lying? No, we're performing reconciliatory taqiyya, which means what? I could say my real beliefs. And I could come out openly with my real beliefs. But I appreciate there are certain figures that you have respect for who I may differ over. When I conceal all my opinions about those figures, it's not because I'm scared, it's because I'm trying to enter dialogue with you as another Muslim. I could come out openly on the minbar with all my opinions about figures in Islamic history, and I can be blunt about it. But reconciliatory taqiyya dictates that I conceal some of my beliefs so that I slowly enter a dialogue with another Muslim, so that I do not offend that Muslim. There are some things you don't come out with openly because the other school will see it as a shock.
Even their most respected unity callers celebrate it. Of course, they disguise the celebration via the acronym. They often post the letters BULB, or even more cowardly, like Mehdi al-Mudarrisi, simply post a light bulb. Sometimes a light bulb is posted with fire around it to signify that Omar radiallahu an is burning in hell fire, as posted here by Hassan Bukhari from the neo-Hindu channel Bayat al-Ghadir. Unlike the cowards like Mudarrisi and Bayat al-Ghadir, some Shias are brave enough to celebrate it openly, like Rafida.org. In the past, their scholar Yash al-Habib has held parties with balloons, dancing, and cake, and broadcasted it on his TV channel, Fedek TV. Here is Ali Shabari dancing in one of these parties. Another hidden way the terrorist attack against Omar is celebrated is through the color red. All over social media, you'll also find Shias posting things with the color red. Some Shias even wear red to celebrate it, just like the hypocrite unity caller Ammar Nakhshawani, who over here is seen wearing a red suit on a program on Imam Hussein TV. Of course, the program is about, you guessed it, Eid al-Zahra. Notice how the presenter is also wearing a red shirt. On the topic of red shirts, I'd like to share a personal anecdote with you. Some of you probably don't know that around half of my family in Bahrain is Shia. One day, I was visiting Bahrain and decided to go to my aunt's house on a Thursday because I knew that's where everyone would gather. This is normal in Bahrain, people usually gather on a Thursday. I was wearing a Manchester United shirt. Once I got to my aunt's house, I saw two of my cousins, who were a couple of years younger than me, waiting outside her front door. I hadn't seen them in a couple of years, so I was pretty happy to see them. However, they didn't look so happy to see me. It was Muharram, and usually during Muharram, my cousins start acting a little bit weird. They spend more time in the Husseiniyya, mourning and wailing. So naturally, there is some kind of distance between myself and them. So I was thinking, that's it. My cousins were both dressed in black. As I approached them, I gave them salam, and the response was, Ali, I've heard you've become a Wahhabi. I was shocked. Is that how you greet a cousin? I'm like, what's wrong with you? They're like, well, you're wearing red. I can see you are celebrating the death of Hussein. I'm like, shut up, man. What are you talking about? I thought they were pulling my legs. They weren't. And naturally, I was quite upset at this. I'm like, whatever. And I just walked past them. Of course, it confused me. After a while, when Muharram's over, usually they stop acting up and things are okay. However, I had no idea what they were talking about. I didn't think too much of it and I kind of dismissed it. However, later on, I came to learn about the celebration, Eid al-Zahra, where Shias wear red in celebration of a killing. So naturally, my cousins thought I was intentionally wearing red in Muharram to celebrate the death of Hussein. I don't blame them. I blame the hateful scholar on the Husseiniya pulpit. In parts of Iraq, it is celebrated with someone dressing up as Omar and then paraded on the streets and beaten by sticks. Omar is portrayed in blackface or a gorilla-like figure as a racist insult towards him, based on some narrations that mention Omar's black ancestry. Let's have a look. The scholars of Ahl al-Sunnah, like Ibn al-Jawzi in his book Virtues of Blacks and Abyssinians, wrote about Omar's Habasha / Ethiopian ancestry. In the Persian supremacist religion of the Rafida, this is what Omar deserves. Racist mockery, being ridiculed with costumes of gorilla-like figures with afro hair. Of course, his slayer, Abu Luluah al Majosi, is portrayed as a white-skinned hero. This should come as no surprise to those well-versed in Twelver Shia theology. They have narrations that are attributed to the infallible imams and considered authentic that are nothing but racist towards black people, such as saying they are distorted creation. For more information on racism in Twelver Shiism, check out our video. Tomb pilgrims wearing clothing displaying the acronym are often seen around Shia shrines. Look how Allah has made these corpse pilgrims humiliate themselves, crawling like cockroaches whilst wearing clothing that curses Omar. Omar al-Faruq, the conqueror of the Majus, would be laughing. We have been informed of an individual by the name Sayyid Tosif Abidi in Bonn, Germany, who runs a fashion store called BUL, in which he sells products like shirts which Omar is cursed via the acronym. The store and label is of course named after the disguised cursing of Omar. The store is often used as a focal point for various Shia gatherings. Here its owner poses at the store with the recently deceased known Sahaba abuser and caller to invoking a horse, Zamir Akhtar Naqvi. Tosif regularly posts pictures and videos of these gatherings on his social media accounts along with vile insults towards the Sahaba. Like this picture of a red bathroom mat as an insult to Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Aisha, may Allah be pleased with them. We call on the Muslim community in Bonn to contact the local authorities explaining the hateful nature of this provocation. In Iran, the celebration has less of a guise of taqiyya and is known as Omar Koshan, or the killing of Omar. The killer of Omar, Abu Luluah al Majusi, even has a shrine in Iran. The tomb is visited and venerated by Shias, who believe that after his terrorist attack against Omar, he was saved by Ali, who used his superpowers, Wilaya al-Takwiniya, and transported Abu Luluah to Iran or Persia, where he stayed until he died. Since the Iranian revolution, Omar Koshan is no longer celebrated publicly. This is what many apologetic Shias like to point out. As if a political step of a contemporary government changes the hateful reality of their religion with this practice. Indeed, the mere public prohibition of this festival was a clever political step by Khomeini. For how can a Shia government fool the Sunni masses and make them believe that Shiism does not propagate the belief of cursing and making takfir of the Sahaba, while on the other hand, every year millions of people could have witnessed how in Iran the Shias literally celebrate the death of Omar. a celebration that was started during the Safavid era, when Persia became majority Shia. Up to the reign of the late Shia, a public celebration where, due to the advocation of the Shia scholars of Qom, the people used to dress in red, recite anti-Omar poems, wrote curses on Omar on the streets and walled, burned Omar puppets, wrote his name inside toilets, and shameful traditions that were always blessed by the Ayatollahs, the so-called scholars of the school of Ahlul Bayt. For more information about the Iranian regime's political correctness and their taqiyya mongering, do check out our documentary, Iranian Shiism Exposed. However, Omar Qoshan is still celebrated in private in Iran. No, this is not a Christmas nor Halloween party. This is Omar Qoshan, or Farhat al-Zahra, in an Iranian home. The puppet on the left is supposed to be Omar, of course depicted as an ugly black man. And on the banner, some poem is written about how the Shia rejoice at his death.
های باریک الله ابو لولو جونم های باریک الله ام های باریک الله های باریک الله بگو های باریک الله ابو لولو جونم
The celebration has a firm historical and theological basis in Twelver Shiism. Many Shia scholars, classical and contemporary, have encouraged their followers to take this date, which according to them was the time Omar was killed, as an Eid. Baqir al Majlisi says that celebrating it is a well-known fact amongst the Shia throughout history. Ayatollah Vahid Khorasani explains how Shias have a strong and detailed evidence that Shia predecessors were upon the view of glorifying the great personality, referring to Abu Luluah al Majosi. Ayatollah Sadiq Rouhani was asked about the celebration of Eid al-Zahra and said it is considered amongst the best means to seek closeness to Allah. Rouhani was asked why the celebration is referred to as the Eid of Baq, cutting and slashing, and answered by saying that it is because it is the day when the belly of one of the enemies of Az-Zahra was slashed open at the hands of the noble Tabi'i Abu Lu'lu'a, and goes on to say, on this day the Shia rejoice.
Sahaba lam ya'tamiru bi'amr Rasulillah falam yaqtulu Umar. المهاجرون لم يأتمروا بأمر رسول الله فلم يقتلوا عمر الأنصار لم يأتمروا بأمر رسول الله فلم يقتلوا عمر زين أصحاب بيعة الشجرة لم يأتمروا بأمر رسول الله فلم يقتلوا عمر من ائتمر بأمر رسول الله فقتل عمر المسلم المؤمن المتقي الورع الشجاع الجريء الباسل أبو إسلام المعروف بأبي لؤلؤ رضوان الله تعالى عليه. هذا هو المسلم الذي ائتمر بأمر رسول الله فقتل عمر. أما الصحابة فكفار، أما الأنصار فكفار، أما المهاجرون فكفار، أما الذين كانوا أصحاب بيعة العقبة فكفار. أبو إسلام المعروف بأبي لؤلؤة هو المسلم الذي ائتمر بأمر رسول الله فقتل عمر صلوات الله عليه ولعنة الله على عمر.
The grand Shia scholar Abdul Hussein al-Naishaburi in his book Taqwim al-Shia discussed and mentioned the day when Omar ibn al-Khattab was stabbed. Under the heading of the death of Omar ibn al-Khattab, he said, this day, meaning the 9th of Rabi al Awal, is the day of happiness of the Ahl al-Bayt. This is because on that day, the call of the oppressed mistress Fatima al-Zahra has been answered. This is a great day and a great Eid. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself made it a day of Eid and ordered the people to take it as an Eid. In the book Farhat al-Zahra, The Rejoice of Fatima Zahra by Abu Ali al-Isfahani, he explains how this Eid has many virtues, such as it is from the greatest and most important of Eids, and that it is reported that the Imams themselves celebrated on this day. Not just themselves, rather they ordered their Shias and followers to consider this day an Eid and to celebrate and rejoice on that day. And then goes on to give examples of the Imam celebrating and encouraging their followers to celebrate this day, as well as speaking about the merits of it. Here you have Al-Qatra website of the Shia cleric, Yasir al-Khabith, which states that a number of major Shia scholars have been buried next to Abu Lu'lu'a. So it is irrelevant if some Shias do not celebrate this hateful festival. Just because some do not celebrate it does not mean that all of a sudden this hateful history and statements of their scholars suddenly disappear. Some of these shocking elements may be unknown to some Muslims today, and even to some Shias, who have some humanity and Iman left inside them, who do not know the reality of this shirki rafidi religion and the hateful celebrations it has. But nevertheless, this hateful celebration is part of Twelver Shiism, backed by giant scholars of this sect throughout history, as well as many contemporaries today. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.